So by a show of hands, how many of you have watched Grey's Anatomy or any medical TV show? Well, let me tell you, hospitals are nothing like what you see on TV, with fast-paced drama and witty doctors solving medical mysteries. Most days in a hospital, we have a regular job, with piling medical records to complete, long phone calls with insurance companies, and in constant search for some good, refreshing coffee. But this was an unexpectedly eye-opening day for me, the day I discovered a superpower. I was a resident trainee, and with only a few night calls under my belt, I was still relatively fresh and new to handling emergencies in medicine. I was completing a long 14-hour night call, and as I was getting to the end of it, I suddenly heard the nurse call out my name in panic, "Dr. Fernandes!" I rushed across the hallway into the patient's room, and there lay before me little Tommy, a 4-month-old. He was blue, pale, and lifeless. In those brief few seconds, but what seemed like eternity, my mind tried to grapple all that I could see, like the pale skin of this baby, hearing the beeping of the monitor, and feeling the icy chill of the room. The nurse had rushed out to call for help, and here I was, alone with this baby. In critical moments like these, with a life hanging in the balance, even the most experienced of doctors can feel overwhelmed, panic, fearful. In similar situations in our own lives, we freeze up, our mind freezes up, and this is primarily because our brain accesses old emotions, triggers unresolved feelings, and starts negative thought loops. Like, I don't think I can do this. I'm just not good enough. Everyone thinks I'm a failure. I am a failure. But something extraordinary happened to me that day. Instead of succumbing to these thought loops, I experienced a pause. And in that pause, I felt a calm wash over me. It was like as if my brain had accessed a space or a reserve of resilience and focus. My entire focus was on little Tommy. No fear, no anxiety. I immediately recognized what I needed to do. I repositioned his head and started to give him breaths. And the subsequent decisions came easily to my surprise. This pause was initiated by specialized networks in our brain called the precuneus. The hippocampus, as you all see, is the memory storehouse in our brain. It pulls out all the learned information, behaviors, and experiences, matches it up with the current situation unfolding before you, and then sends this information over to the sensor alarm in the brain, which starts out all those negative thought loops, like a warning system. But this precuneus is special. It breaks these negative thought loops through a process called metacognition. Metacognition is like thinking about your thought patterns. Imagine you're studying for a test or you're preparing for something important and you start to feel anxious. Your heart is racing, you're sweating. So you take a pause and you reflect on what is it that is making me feel this way. And you recognize that you're worried. Worried about the preparation, worried about recalling all this information for the next day. That ability to recognize that the worry is causing the anxiety is metacognition. And this metacognition within our brain is rooted in our evolution. We all started out as reptiles with a reptilian brain, this brain continues to control our basic survival instincts, like breathing. We then, as early mammals, developed social behaviors, communication, emotions, and formed the limbic brain. And today, as an advanced species, we now have what we call the neocortex or the new cortex. This neocortex exerts its influence on both the limbic brain and the reptilian brain. Your memory storehouse, sensor alarm are in that limbic brain, and your abilities like advanced reasoning, thinking, sophisticated language, self-awareness, and metacognition reside in the neocortex. To be able to harness this evolutionary marvel that exists within each one of us, we need to activate neurons in our brain through a process called neuroplasticity. Think of neuroplasticity. Imagine your brain like a wide city with different neighborhoods. These neighborhoods are connected by roads, or what we call neural pathways. When neuroplasticity kicks in, it brings along with it specialized construction workers that can either widen existing roads or even create new ones. Research shows that individuals who are able to strengthen their metacognitive ability are better at regulating their emotions. As a result, they are less stressed and able to bounce back from stress much faster. For all of us, this is like a superpower. As I went through my journey and I questioned the neuroscience behind all these experiences, I found an interesting connection. We learned in science that there are nerve networks that support both metacognition and our intuition. And there is a common brain region that supports both these abilities. And what feeds these abilities are nerve networks around our gut, our heart, and the rest of our nervous system. And this brings to my mind this famous psychiatrist and author, Dr. Gabor Mate, who tells us that we have three brains in our body, essentially the heart brain, the gut brain, and the cerebral brain that all of you are aware of. And then he goes on to give us a powerful statement. He says, when one is disconnected from the other two, you can have all kinds of science and all kinds of logic and all kinds of technology, but you lack the wisdom to heal and feel whole. To feel whole is not merely an absence of disease. It is the full and optimal functioning of the human organism according to its nature-gifted possibilities. This highlights the vital connection between metacognition, intuition, and our health. Currently, the World Health Organization describes the dimensions of health within the framework of physical, mental, emotional, social, and spiritual. Our current government healthcare policies, healthcare models, infrastructure, research, funding, all of this is primarily focused on the physical domain, a mental, emotional domain, and to some extent, the social domain. But the spiritual domain that harnesses qualities like metacognition, intuition, self-awareness are often left underutilized. This spiritual domain should not be confused with solely religious beliefs. Rather, it is seen in health and defined in health as a way in which an individual finds ultimate meaning and purpose through connection. Connection with the self, nature, or the transcendent. Practices that tap into this spiritual domain include those like meditative practices, contemplative practices, and techniques that tap into electrochemical channels within our body. A great example of this is Tai Chi, which is used in medicine. And research is now showing these practices, techniques, increase the frontal structures of our brain, namely the precuneus, the prefrontal cortex, which has association with how we behave. It enhances our metacognition and protects us against dementia or memory loss. All those of you who have seen the 2024 Olympics and have seen these great athletes that tap into this spiritual domain, they have used meditative practices to channel their Zen-like focus, metacognitive abilities into winning medals. This supports the idea that nurturing our spiritual health in turn strengthens our mental emotional state. And as a result, it improves our entire physical well-being. And this has been my own personal experience too. After completing medical school, I felt quite disconnected from myself and those around me. This is a common experience that many doctors go through. I set out on a journey of self-discovery, curious about the ancient health wisdom that so many generations before me had benefited from. I utilized practices like meditation, spiritual techniques, under the right guidance, and I found that connection with myself. And this connection has given me effortlessly a lasting sense of peace, the ability to express my true qualities, and most importantly, the strength to be able to overcome any situation that comes my way. Like in little Tommy's case, I was so focused on little Tommy, and I'm happy to share the good news that little Tommy made it. Questioning the neuroscience behind these experiences, I took a deep dive into the research and found growing benefits like metacognition, and there's still more research coming out. What we've seen is that behind this neuroscience research, there are so many growing benefits like improved structure and function of our brain. So I then supported the development of two pilot studies that looked into a unique meditative process called Maitreya Dadashreeji. And we found increased connections within the precuneus on specialized MRI scans. And if you all recall from earlier in this talk, the precuneus is one of the pivotal regions for metacognition. Whilst I know, as of today, the results, the research, it only scratches the surface of an undiscovered realm. Yet, it gives me the motivation to continue my scientific exploration, but at the same time, advocate for spiritual health. Because the nation needs it, now more than ever. Last year, in 2023, the US Surgeon General's office put out stats that half of the American population is feeling disconnected, experiencing loneliness, half. Staggering numbers that are experiencing depression, anxiety, work-related stress, and succumbing to drug abuse. We need a shift in the way we deliver healthcare. We need an integrative healthcare model that includes all the domains of health. And the good news is, this shift is starting. This integrative domain of health, or this model of health, is a comprehensive toolbox. It consists of our conventional advanced modern science, like medications, surgeries, use of gene therapies, the use of AI in medicine, but at the same time, traditional tools that are rooted in ancient health wisdom, like nutritional sciences, mind-body medicine, meditative techniques, spiritual practices, just to name a few. Renowned institutions like the Veteran Affairs Hospitals have now launched the Whole Health Program, which adopts an integrative healthcare model for our veterans. Leading organizations like the Mayo Clinic, MD Anderson Cancer Center now offer integrative oncology for our cancer patients. And universities like Harvard and Stanford are now offering training programs for our upcoming generation of healthcare professionals. I am not here to advocate a return to the dark ages of medicine, where we are prescribing mercury or toxic herbs to our patients. Nor am I suggesting that everything natural is inherently safe. What I am here to do is open your mind to this idea that we can integrate ancient health wisdom with modern advancing science. And let's bring back the benefits that we may have lost over time. Let us be that audacious generation, united in our quest to heal and feel whole. Before I conclude, I would like to leave you all with a question to access your superpower, your metacognition. Who can you be when you realize your true purpose and fulfill your full potential? Thank you.